The Knights Templar, one of history's most mysterious armies, were an underground fighting force more secretive than the Illuminati.
By 1312, the Templars became so powerful that the Pope ordered them to be hunted down and destroyed.
As the story goes, the Templars are rounded up, tortured, and burned alive. Thousands of once all-powerful knights vanish overnight. And with them, their hidden treasures and immense wealth. Vanished. Gone.
But new evidence recently discovered in ancient navigational charts suggests that they may have survived and rebuilt the Templar Order somewhere in the New World. This is the Zeno Map. Some believe it documents a top-secret mission to keep the Sacred Order alive. Led by a Templar named Henry Sinclair, it is said that roughly 100 Templars traveled from the north of Scotland to America in 1398, nearly a century before Columbus set foot on the continent.
So what is this map trying to show us?
Well, this secret expedition was heading to the New World, then the final destination would be the westernmost point on the map, which if we look over here, it's Estoti Land. What is Estoti Land? Where is that supposed to be? And if we look at the route between Europe and Estoti Land, you have these massive islands in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean that we know don't exist.
These are all phantom islands, meaning they don't correspond directly to any landmass on a modern map. What are these islands trying to represent? Finding out could be the key to discovering the Templar secret destination.
All right, so if we compare these two maps, Scotia is Scotland.
Clearly.
Norvegia would be Norway.
Right.
We've got Iceland, we've got Greenland, which takes us over here to that western point on the map. So if we take a look, with everything else in position, then Estoti Land would be Nova Scotia.
Well, that's actually really interesting because Nova Scotia in Latin means New Scotland. And as we know, Henry Sinclair's voyage left from Scotland.
So is the Zeno map trying to tell us that Nova Scotia was the end destination of Henry Sinclair's secret expedition?
And could this be the location of where the Templars resettled in America? Think about being in the medieval era with a wooden ship, potentially carrying the Ark of the Covenant and the Holy Grail.
That is an epic journey.
Absolutely outrageous.
It sounds like a myth. It also contradicts the history books.
So what is the story with Henry Sinclair?
The Knights Templar were dissolved. Most of them were murdered.
1307, right?
Right.
Right.
And then the thought process is that Henry Sinclair and a group of the Knights Templar were hiding out in Scotland. And then they took what was left of their fortune and set out west, hoping to find a place to kind of resettle. Essentially, this like secret mission, hoping to save their lives and protect what was left of their massive fortune. So some people theorize that in the late 1300s, Henry Sinclair and a group of his Knights Templar came all the way to here, Nova Scotia, and actually landed over 100 years before Christopher Columbus.
That's incredible.
There's a gentleman we're meeting from the Mi'kmaq Nation. He's also a historian named Tim Sock. He claims to have a rock-solid piece of evidence that connects Henry Sinclair and Knights Templar to his ancestors.
Who were his ancestors?
The Mi'kmaq people. And so he claims that they did meet and they did interact, and he's going to show us something that can help prove that.
That's interesting. So Tim has what he believes is evidence of a first contact between Henry Sinclair and the Mi'kmaq people somewhere here in Nova Scotia, as proof that it's not merely a myth or a legend or a tall tale, but actual historical fact. That's absolutely fascinating. I can't wait to see it.
Evan Pritchard is a professor of Native American studies and an expert on Nova Scotia's history.
We're really interested in this idea of the Knights Templar coming to Nova Scotia. And certainly we're also very interested in any interactions with the indigenous peoples.
It's possible that the Knights Templar came and intermixed with Mi'kmaq people.
Really?
Because all of Nova Scotia is basically Mi'kmaq territory. And this would be part of the evidence.
Through his research, Evan has mapped out the territories occupied by the Mi'kmaq. Going back over 10,000 years, they were the first indigenous people in Nova Scotia. Nomads, who lived and traveled along the region's waterways. So it's incredibly likely they would have witnessed this band of warrior knights' momentous arrival on the shores here in 1398.
What kind of evidence do you have of that?
There's a lot of different ways to tie in Mi'kmaq with the Knights Templar. For one thing, the Knights Templar wore chaperone hats.
These are the hats that members of the Templar Order would wear when aiding people on pilgrimage to Jerusalem.
Yes. And so the Mi'kmaq, even today, wear this chaperone hat in ceremony.
So you think this hat is evidence of a meeting between the Templars and the Mi'kmaq?
I do.
Incredible.
History says the Templars never left Europe. So how is it possible that Nova Scotia's indigenous people, living in the exact place where a secret Templar mission could have landed, are seen wearing Templar garments?
There's an additional part of the evidence. This is the Mi'kmaq ceremonial flag. And what's interesting is this one is the Templar battle flag. And there you see the similarity.
This is huge. According to Evan, there's no evidence of the Mi'kmaq using flags until after the Templars would have arrived in Nova Scotia. Add to that, the flags are nearly identical.
You're saying that there wasn't just a point of first contact, but an actual bond was forged between the Mi'kmaq people and the Templars?
Yes, that's what I believe.
Wow.
Based on Evan's information, the Mi'kmaq people could be the key to picking up the trail of the Templars' activity in America. So we're heading 100 miles southwest to Cape Fourchou.
Wow, this is pretty.
Where we've managed to set up a meeting with Tim Sock.
Hey Tim, how you doing?
He's a member of the Mi'kmaq tribe and has been researching the oral history of his people for over 30 years.
Welcome to the unceded territory of the Mi'kmaq people.
Thanks for having us.
So Tim, we're hoping to find out if the Mi'kmaq passed down any stories or legends about the Templars that could possibly help us track their movements here in America.
Traditional oral history, over thousands of years, we've had stories of the Templar. They weren't known as the Templar to my people. They were known as white garbed with a symbol on them.
What was the symbol?
It was like a cross symbol on them.
Okay.
So to us now, today, we know that as the Templar.
So are there stories about Henry Sinclair that you know about?
Sinclair's people, they were on the water a very long time. My people took them in, helped them. We're the first Aboriginal people or Native people to be impacted by the European presence.
According to the Mi'kmaq oral tradition, around 1398, along these very shores, Tim's ancestors watched as Europeans wearing white robes and blazoned with crosses sailed their boats towards this land, nearly 100 years before Columbus would reach North America. The Templars made landfall.
Oh, there's the ocean, huh?
Yeah, this
gorgeous.
Is the Atlantic meeting the Bay of Fundy.
You're saying this is a possibly spot that they might have actually came in, Sinclair and his crew?
Well, the water's deep enough, right? You can get a ship down in here. So he could have landed here.
There's a ship crossing right now.
Exactly. And to my people, that'd bring everybody up because that'd be surprising to them to see a large ship, right?
Right.
You're only in dugout canoes, birch bark canoes, would have been extravagant to them.
Looking closely at the Zeno map, we can see a small inlet that could be representing the Bay of Fundy, potentially further proof that the Templars landed here.
So Tim, oral history is obviously valuable, but is there any actual tangible evidence that they landed in this place?
Over here, the Overton Stone.
Just 150 feet from the shore, where the secret Templar landing may have taken place, sits the centuries-old Overton Stone. At its center are two deeply chiseled carvings. The first, a feather and moon, symbols used by the Mi'kmaq. The second, a Templar cross.
To me, it shows that the Templar were here and the Mi'kmaq were with them. It shows they're being guided by the Mi'kmaq people.
It's like a sign that this is a
sign we were here, we're launching out.
So it's not a myth that Henry St. Clair came.
No.
It's fact.
It's fact.